What's going on everyone? In this video I decided to have another shot at lure fishing for perch on my local stretch of canal. Spoiler alert, I actually did end up catching one, and it was a lot bigger than I would have anticipated. So make sure to stick along until the end to see the build up of catching this beauty. Let's dive right into it. Enjoy.
In this video, I'm going to be attempting to catch some perch on the smallest lure I could find. I'm currently just walking down to a spot I recently found that I thought would be quite good for perch fishing. I think this because it's completely under structure, under like some little bridge area over the other side of the canal. I'll show you when I get there. But for now, I've got a bit of a walk ahead of me, so I'll speed that up for you guys, and I'll see you when I'm there. Okay, so I'm now at the spot where I'm going to be fishing, and as you can see, it's all over there, just like balcony area. And there's supposed to be quite a lot of perch under there, or at least I think so. So I'm just going to get casting away with the little lure. I'm just going to cast a bunch of times underneath all of the stretch of this little balcony thing. Let's get right into it. First cast out of the video, well not the first, but the first on camera. I've had a few before and my casts, as you can just tell, they're horrific. I don't know what's wrong with it. I think I need to set the weight of this little lure, because the lure, it weighs nothing at all. So it's not going to get very much range. And I'm trying to cast all the way over there underneath that. I've just had a little bit of action with it, to be honest, guys. Loads of little vibrations came on the lure, which definitely bites. So I'm going to keep casting out here, right ahead of me. That's exactly where I casted, just perfect. And I'm reeling in, like, super slow, so that the perch can get to it, like, and see what they're trying to eat. Thought I was hooked on a fish, but no. I realised it was a big snag. And as this place, it's absolutely full of snags where I am right now. As I found out the other day in one of my latest videos, I went down there lure fishing and I lost one of my newest lures. At this point, I'm starting to think I've casted a bit too much in this area because I've been reeling in. I've felt a few bites, but nothing's been hooked on as of yet. But I suppose I'm feeling bites, which is a good sign. But as you can tell, I've changed my methods. I'm reeling in very slowly because perch apparently attack slow bite, like slower things, slow like. In this video though, I'm going to be heading all the way down there to the other stretch of this canal because it gets narrower and a lot of perch lurk there apparently. And of course down there I've never fished before, so this will be like fresh waters for me. I've never fished. I'm going to get a wriggle on and I'm going to come back to this area later on in the video. But for now, before it gets dark, I want to go down there. At the moment, I'm just fishing out this spot where I was earlier. Not earlier, in a different video I say. But I want to see if I can get one from here, because I know some pike lurk around here. In fact, I'm not even joking when I say this. I've just seen one jump there, a massive one as well. But yeah, I hope I catch one. I'm pretty sure I will. Now, from this point here onwards, I've never fished before, so this could be some new encounters with new fish, you know what I mean? I'll start out by casting into those big reeds over there. That looks like a fish lurking spot. For this session as well, I've took the wire trace off of the rod so that the perch, like, they won't see it, because apparently wire traces, like, put them off biting, basically. The sunset over there is stunning, but that means that it's going to get dark soon, so I've got to get a wriggle on. I found a bit more structure here. There's some more, like, balcony-looking things, which provides shelter for fish, so I'd imagine they'd hide under there. The spot where I'm at now, I've been casting out there and having nothing, but if you look right down below, you might be able to see on camera, there's little, right there, you can see all these weeds growing from the side. And now I can see, you probably can't, but there is a little school of fish there. And there might be little perch, there could be little minnows, could be little anything. But I'm going to see if anything will bite. I'm just holding the middle of the rod right now, because I'm just moving it along basically. I guarantee if I was to come out on one weekend on a day and just walk down the margins of the canal with a little lure in, I'd bag up, I guarantee. In the distance, I can just about see where it starts to get narrow, and I'm gonna race over to there now, and I'm just gonna come back to this bit at the end because the sun is setting quite a lot faster than I expected, to be honest. I'll come here pretty open over there and you can just see it going down. It's going down fast. So I'm gonna just race down to that narrow part and I'm gonna go a good 10 minutes fishing there. On the way down, I couldn't resist but to stop at this place here. You can't see it again on camera, but it's so shallow and so clear, and it definitely looks like a spot where a perch might just come out of the bank. Right, there's one right there. I'm not being funny, there's a perch there. Let me see if I can attract him. Oh, I've spooked him, he's gone. From this point onwards, as you can see, it starts to get a lot narrower, so this is where it gets narrow basically, and I'm going to start casting the hell out of this place.
At this point, I was considering going home, as a barge had just come past and disturbed all of the swims I was planning on casting out to. But then I felt something on the rod, and then this happened.
Look what I've just whipped up on this lure. No way, my first ever fish on a lure, and it's actually a pretty big perch. Look at that, I was just there, on the narrow bit, and he absolutely smashed the thing. I felt it, like, tugging, and this thing came out. You know what, I'm not being funny, this is a new PB perch. It might not be actually my PB perch. It was a bit bigger and fatter than that, but he's not far off. Gonna unhook the fella right now. He's cooked himself quite decent actually, right through the gill, not the gill, the little bit of mouth there. I'll unhook him off camera. I've got some forceps actually, so I'll use them. I'm buzzing with that though. I've never caught a fish on a lure before. And then I whip up, wow, he's a flopper. I'll calm him down real. Like, never caught one on a lure before, and then I catch this. I'm buzzing. Look at him with his big spine up. I'm gonna pop him back in the water now though, because he's been out for a while. Off you go, monster. Wow, never knew lure fishing was that good. I love it now. First fish on a lure, I'm happy with that. I'm gonna cast the loving life out of this place now and hopefully get some more in this video. I'm getting straight back out. I kind of wish that I'd have bought my net and mat now, because I didn't realise I'd be catching things like that. Because I've never really been lure fishing, so I didn't know what type of fish I'd catch. Well, I knew what type of fish I'd catch. I said that wrong. I didn't know how big the fish that I would catch be. So, future note to myself, always bring a mat and a net lure fishing. Tell you what, I'm absolutely buzzing now. I'm just rushing. I want to catch another one so badly. I love it. I love lure fishing now. Now I know I can catch. Here we go. I'm in bites. Oh, no, I wasn't. I thought I had a bite, but it was the lure. It come to the very end. A barge did just come past. Like, the second I caught the fish, actually, I was thinking to myself, I hope I catch one before he comes. And I caught one just as I thought that. But now the barge is gone, he may have scared the fish away. As you can see, it's got really dark really fast, but I'm feeling little bites. Little tiny ones. Nothing, though. I really want to catch another one. That was insane. Like, I didn't even have to set the hook or nothing. The fish just whopped it. Like, he bit it all. You guys are probably watching this thinking, I'm like, whoa, how's he not know this? But I've never caught one on a lure before. So that was my first ever catch on a lure. And it was quite a big perch. So as I've said about 20 times, I'm really happy with it. I'm heading back up the canal stretch now. And I'm going to stop where I caught my fish. And I'm going to fish there again. Just in case he wants to bite again. Here's the spot. It's a bit in the light as well. My plan of fishing there again obviously did not work, because do you see a fish? No. So I'm going to walk back up now. Now I've caught the perch, I'm going in for a pike. No, I'm not. The lure is not big enough for a pike, unless he was really hungry and wanted a snack. But I don't think the pike would bite this lure at all. The bites have slowed down. I say that, but the bites haven't slowed down at all. It's just a pretty average lure fishing session for me now. Not catching anything. Except I have, but no, this is all right. I'm gonna give it until I get back up to that wharf now. I'm just gonna lure fish up until then and then pack up, because I do need to get home before the dark comes. Basically, I've got about 10 minutes more fishing. So in 10 minutes, let's see what I can catch. Well guys, I've reached back up at the wharf and I've had no more luck. I think I already pushed my luck though, catching that big fish with the lure. So I'm gonna end the video up now. What a little session it's been though. It's been a lovely evening, just lure fishing this section of canal. And I actually caught something for once. After about 10 lure fishing videos, I finally caught one. I'm definitely gonna come back down here in a future video and do some more lure fishing. I'll probably come down on a weekend for a full entire day and let's see what we can catch then. I mean, I probably would have caught another one just, but a barge came past, as I said, so that probably disturbed the swing quite a bit. But yes, what a video it's been. I loved that session. And I hope you guys did too. So, if you enjoyed, please smash the thumbs up button for me. It means a lot and helps out the channel quite a bit. Whilst you're down there liking the video, you might as well subscribe if you're not already subscribed. So, do that please. When you subscribed, please turn the post notification bell on as well, so you never miss another one of my videos. But for now guys, I'll see you all here in the next video. Peace. Thanks for watching that video guys, but before you leave, I'm just going to give you a quick update on my fish. As you can see, the tank's looking very active. There's one of my new ones, and all the fish are out at the moment actually. I did get another new one, exactly like that one, but he just likes to hide at the back there because he gets a little bit bullied by that one for some reason. But aside from that, everything else in the tank is doing amazing. The cribbances are hiding down there. That's the peacock cichlid, I believe, and he's doing good. And then obviously the rest are all amazing. And the ruby shark's just there. But I'll give you guys interested in that quick update on it.